Hey, good morning. I haven't showered and really haven't slept well. I don't have heat, and the radiators are making this ridiculous noise. It's like torture. And you know all those commercials? I think we've moved into legalized drug pushing. You know, you in your lives have never seen so many commercials for drugs. And I know in the 60s that they wanted to police it, and to date, you know, people want to police it, but they're never going to police the pharmaceuticals. They're not only above it, but they get the New York Times to push whatever they're trying to make loads and loads of money on. They can sell on the internet, they advertise on the internet, the television, at bookstores, you name it, whatever they're trying to push and convince us we need. So I took an Ambien, and I gotta tell you, it makes me feel so awful. I don't feel like I had a good night's sleep, but it did prevent me from hearing this this unbelievable noise. So what is that? How is this all political? Well, one, I wouldn't be here if Mayor Bloomberg did what he was supposed to do and protect the community, our historic buildings, and if he hadn't sold St. Anne's, and you have to visit it, 120 East 12th Street, and see the facade from 1847 that survived everything but NYU's need and greed to build yet another mega dorm, and supersized on our old infrastructure right near all the other mega dorms by the subways, which is really dangerous. And also Cooper Union wants a supersize right by that subway that's not in good shape. For me, I believe there's a lot of danger and concerns, aren't environmental, below the ground with pipes. It won't break in front of any of their new buildings. It breaks down the street. And then the landlord has to pay. Pretty convenient. May force rents to go up higher, may force more people to leave. It goes on and on and on. The subways are jam-packed. So how does that tie in? It all ties in. If the mayor had done what he was supposed to do, protect the people rather than do everything for the developers, for NYU, Columbia University, Cooper Union. Yeah, they're developers, they're real estate magnates. And it's not just them, it's Trump, you name it. It's all the developers. I wouldn't be in this situation. And what happened is more and more, it just, the neighborhood took on the vibe of being NYU. The building that I loved for 20 years has a bank in the base. It's like, it looks more and more like an NYU dorm to me. So I'm a wreck. I just had to tell you guys, I don't know what to say. It's like a bad dream. You know, 9/11 was the worst. I don't want to cry, but that was the worst. But on and on, it just feels like this can't be happening. This is a bad dream. When am I going to wake up from this? It's just, and it's all corruption. It's all very, very corrupt. And I don't feel, there's no political leader I can say, gee, I look up to you. You're going to really help us. There's nobody in power that I feel can make a dent. There's one city council member, Tony Avella, that I think is awesome, and he's dared to speak up. But can he make a dent? No. Do I believe he's integrity? Yes. He's one of such a small, small percentage of people. Just, you know, from the top of city government down to the most humblest levels, you have a few good apples, but just only a few. And it's heartbreaking.